Okay, so now the next chapter is structural organization in animals. Structural organization in animals. Structural organization in animals. This is the organization of the animals, that what organisms are involved and what are the various types of the cells or the tissues or the various components, we can say, that which makes up that organism. ठीक है, तो हमने यहाँ पे क्या करना है, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन पढ़ना है एनिमल्स का स्ट्रक्चर बेस पे. ठीक है, ओनली ऑन डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द स्ट्रक्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. अगर हम ये ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की बात करें तो वी नो दैट वी हैव स्टडीड सिंस आवर लोअर क्लासेस, थर्ड क्लास में स्टार्ट कर देते हैं जब आप साइंस एज अ सब्जेक्ट पढ़ना शुरू करते हो, तो वहां पे आपको कराते हैं सेलुलर लेवल्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. यू रिमेम्बर सेलुलर लेवल्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. यू स्टार्ट स्टडिंग इट फ्रॉम द टाइम दैट यू स्टार्ट स्टडिंग योर साइंस. What are these cellular levels of organization? Cellular level means that there is a basic level of the living organism, and that is cell. Okay, cell is a basic level of organism. The cells, they unite forming tissues, they aggregate forming tissues, tissues aggregate forming organs, organs aggregate forming the organ systems, right? So this is one organ from a clubbed type of the tissues. Then from many of the organs, organ system will be made. From the organ system, hence the organism is made. And here we are talking about the organism only, that is the animals. Or animals kya hai? Organisms, theek hai? Animals bane kahan se? Ye organism bana kahan se? Humans kahan se bane? Organ systems jab ye aggregate kiye. Organ systems in sari cheezon se club up hote hote bane. Theek hai? अब हमारी बॉडी के अंदर वी हैव द कम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गन सिस्टम्स, वी हैव नंबर ऑफ ऑर्गन सिस्टम्स विच आर वर्किंग फॉर द ऑर्गेनिज्म. तो दैट इज व्हाट मेक्स अवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दैट इज व्हाट मेक्स अवर स्ट्रक्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ठीक है, सो हेयर वी विल बी स्टडिंग द सेल टॉपिक जो है हमारा, ये वाला सेल टॉपिक वी आर टू स्टडी इन अ सेपरेट चैप्टर, दैट इज द थर्ड यूनिट फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज द नेक्स्ट टू दिस चैप्टर जो हमारा, उसमें हम सेल और सेल के कॉम्पोनेंट्स, सारी सेल ऑर्गेनाइज, उनके स्ट्रक्चर, फंक्शंस, व्हाट्स अदर थिंग्स, वो सारी रिलेटेड चीजें हम इसमें पढ़ेंगे सेल चैप्टर. ठीक है, देन कमिंग टू द ऑर्गन्स एंड द ऑर्गन सिस्टम्स, वी ऑल स्टडी दीज लेवल्स इन द ऑर्गन सिस्टम्स, वी स्टडी दीज इन द फिफ्थ यूनिट ऑफ योर सिलेबस. फिफ्थ यूनिट दैट विच कंसिस्ट ऑफ द एनिमल फिजियोलॉजी, एनिमल्स. ठीक है, वहां पे हम ये सारा ऑर्गन सिस्टम, ऑर्गन्स, ये चीजें पढ़ेंगे. ऑर्गेनिजम्स के बिहेवियर्स के बारे में अगर हम बात करें, what are the different organisms, what are their various characteristics, plants, animals, ye sari cheeze agar hum padhe, so that is unit number 1 and the chapters are, ek hum kar chuke hain biological classification and kingdom plantae and animalia, they are left. Theek hai, so this also we have to study in a separate of the chapters. So here in this chapter, that is the structural organization, we have to study only about the tissues, means that we will be studying for all the cellular levels of organization in your 11th. We will be studying about all the things. Organ nahi maine mark kiya, to organ isi ke saath hai. Theek hai, organ system that comprises of the various organs. So this is, we are to study all the levels, all the cellular levels of organization in your 11th bio syllabus, right? But from this chapter, structural organization in animals, we are to study first about the tissues. Then next to the tissues in this same chapter, we have the topics of the different organisms also. That is three animals, unki aage organization samjhai hui hai. That is of the earthworm, cockroach and the frog. Right? But aapke syllabus mein, CBSE mein, that all has been deleted. Okay? For you people, that all has been deleted. Earthworm, frog and cockroach, they are not going to come in your papers, in your exam. The only portion of this chapter we have to deal is tissues. That is animal tissues, that's it. Okay, then don't go for the cockroach, earthworm and the frog then. Okay, so this is what we have to start with today, and that is tissues topic, right? So coming to the tissues, what are tissues? Tissue is the aggregation of cells, we can say, right? Tissue is an aggregation of what type of the cells? It can be of similar or dissimilar cells. It is an aggregation. Aggregation means that it's a grouping of the cells, grouping of similar or dissimilar cells, similar or dissimilar cells, but performing similar or dissimilar is in the form of the or in on the basis of its structure. Okay, the aggregation of the similar or dissimilar cells performing common function, performing same function, performing a common function, that is what makes it a tissue. This is what makes it a tissue, because they all club up, they all aggregate for what? For performing this common function. Okay, similar dissimilar ki wali jo baat aati hai वो यूजली प्लांट सेल्स में होता है. ये प्लांट सेल्स में होते हैं जहां डिसिमिलर सेल्स क्लब अप करते हैं. दैट इज फॉर जाइलम एंड द फ्लोएम. यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड इट इन योर नाइन्थ क्लास. देयर वाज अ टिश्यू चैप्टर, तो आपने पढ़ा है प्लांट्स में. एनिमल्स, यहाँ पे हमने एनिमल्स करने हैं. तो एनिमल्स में यू विल सी दैट दिस इज एन एग्रीगेशन ऑफ द सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ द सेल्स परफॉर्मिंग ऑल द कॉमन फंक्शंस. ओके, सो नाउ वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ दीज टिश्यूज, टाइप्स ऑफ द टिश्यूज. Next, types of tissues. The tissues, they perform the same function depending upon their different functions or depending upon their structural dissimilarities, because one is different from the another. Okay, so depending upon that, here are four types of the tissues that which we have to study, right? What are the four types of the tissues of the animals that we have to study here? Number one are the epithelial tissues. Epithelial tissue. Number two are connective tissues. Number three, there is muscular tissue providing all movements in the body of an animal, because animals, they are different from plants, saying that these can move, the plants can't move. So that is because of this tissue, muscular tissue. Okay, and the last is we can respond also to the provided stimulus, and so we have the nervous tissue as well. So this is the nervous tissue that is providing response to stimuli. Tissue involved is nervous, conducting the information of the response or the stimulus, that is the nervous tissue. Got it? Right? So next is we have to study these all in details, all the types of these tissues in details. We have several types of the epithelial, connective, then three types of the muscular, and then only one structure, that for nervous tissue, we have to study from this chapter. Okay, so coming to the first, that is the epithelial tissues in details. The epithelial tissue, that is further of two types, right? Epithelial tissue, give it a heading, epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue, it is further of two types. This basic tissue of the animals, it's further of two types, that is simple epithelium and compound epithelium. Simple and compound. Simple and compound. The simple and compound epithelium, they are named because of the layering, because of the presence of the cells in the form of the layers. If it is a single layer, if it is a single flat thin sheet which is made of the cells forming a tissue, it is simple. Okay, that is, it is a simple type of the epithelial tissue. It will be called as a compound when there will be the layering will be done for the cells. ठीक है, जो cells हैं उनकी layering हो जाएगी, तो it will be called as further as a compound epithelial tissue, right? So you can write simple epithelium is when only one layer is formed by the aggregation of the cells. That is all simple epithelium. Next is compound epithelium. When multiple layers are formed, multi-layered structures formed by the aggregation of cells forms a compound tissue. Okay, compound epithelium. Now coming to the simple epithelium again, This further has three of its subtypes.
What are the three subtypes of it?
Number one are the squamous epithelium.
Squamous epithelium.
Second are cuboidal epithelium. And the third are columnar epithelium.
Columnar epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, and squamous epithelium. Got it? Further, squamous epithelium that has a viscous structure function on the patient. Ki agar hum baat karein. So, squamous, as the name is saying, square means square. Okay, it's a square shaped structure. So, they have thin and flat
layer is formed of square shaped cells. Okay, it's square shaped cells, right?
That is squamous epithelium. Squamous mein beta UVA, SQUA. This is squamous epithelium. Okay, this is SQUAMOUS, squamous, right? So this is thin or flat layer of square shaped cells that forms the squamous epithelium, right? How is the structure of the squamous epithelium? Whatsoever the epithelial tissue is present, they always be, you can say, provide the function of lining, right?
Lining ka ek role play karte hain ye. Dusra, they provide the function of absorption. And tisra, they are involved in performing the function of secretion, right? So all these epithelium tissues, they are providing the lining, absorption, and secretion. So these are the common functions, you can say, the three common functions for all the epitheliums. Write it down. These are the three functions. Okay? The functions of all the epithelium. Now, what is the structure of the squamous epithelium? The squamous epithelium, let's say, this is the layer on which it will be formed. Okay? We have said that there is lining. Okay? So lining is... This is the lining of the tissue epithelium. I'm erasing these. First, we are studying the first type so that diagrams can be visible. So this is for squamous epithelium. Jahan pe bhi ye tissues lining banayenge. Lining means there is, let's say, this is a cross section of an elementary canal. Let's say, theek hai. Agar ye elementary canal hai, to isme jo innermost hai, ye hollow structure mein jo innermost hai, that is the skin of my palm. ठीक है, ये वाला जो स्किन है ये एपिथेलियम का बना, ठीक है. व्हाट्स एवर द फूड, लेट्स से दिस चॉक इज अ फूड पार्टिकल, इट हैज टू पास, इट विल बी गोइंग अक्रॉस दिस फूड पाइप. ठीक है, एलिमेंट्री कैनाल जो भी है, स्टमक की लाइनिंग है जो भी, सो इट इज पासिंग अक्रॉस दिस, राइट? टू व्हाट कॉन्टैक्ट इट इज कमिंग? इट इज कमिंग टू द कॉन्टैक्ट ऑफ दिस इनसाइड इनर मोस्ट लेयर, दैट इज द एपिथेलियल लेयर. इसके कॉन्टैक्ट में आ रहा है ना फूड पार्टिकल हमारा, ठीक है, दैट इज द स्किन ऑफ माई पाम्स, राइट? तो यहाँ पे अगर ये सारी लाइनिंग जो है ये एब्जॉर्प्टिव है, जस्ट बिकॉज इट इज कमिंग डायरेक्टली इन कॉन्टैक्ट टू द टिश्यू लाइन, ठीक है. सेकेंडली, इट इज सिक्रेटिव, बिकॉज व्हाट्स एवर द सिक्रेशंस आर रिक्वायर्ड टू डाइजेस्ट दिस फूड पार्टिकल, हु इज प्रोवाइडिंग दिस लेयर्स, है ना, इनर मोस्ट लेयर्स. सो दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग सो दैट दोस सिक्रेशंस दे कम डायरेक्टली इन कॉन्टैक्ट टू द फूड पार्टिकल, है ना. थर्ड थिंग इज दे आर लाइनिंग. लाइनिंग मीन्स दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग सम इनर लाइनिंग. सो अगर ये स्किन का लेयर जो इनर मोस्ट लाइनिंग है, तो वो किसी ना किसी भी बेस लेयर के ऊपर प्रेजेंट होगा, है ना. अगर ये मैं पाम की स्किन लेयर की बात करती हूँ, तो उसके ऊपर कितनी ज्यादा थिकनिंग है, ठीक है. तो ये थिकनिंग जो है, यानी जो उसके पीछे पड़े जो सेल्स हैं, दे प्रोवाइड इट एज अ बेस ऑन विच दीज स्पेशल एपिथेलियल सेल्स कैन बी अरेंज्ड. Got it? So that is they perform the lining. So if it is having the lining type of a condition, it will be formed always on a basement membrane. So for drawing all the types of the epithelial tissues, you will have to draw the basement membrane first. Okay? So this is the basement membrane. The basement membrane that consists of the various tissues along with the blood vessels, jo uske niche, beneath that, right? Now this consists of the square shaped cells. I told you square shaped cells, thin and flat layer banata hai of the square shaped cells. So these are the square shaped cells, right? As they are long, they are white. जितने लंबे उतने ही चौड़े हैं, उतने ही वाइड हैं, सो दैट इज अ स्क्वायर शेप. ठीक है, टॉप सरफेस आपने इस तरह से बल्ज नहीं करना, दैट इज फ्लैट. लिखा ना हमने थिन एंड फ्लैट, तो दैट इज फ्लैट. ठीक है, डू नॉट मेक द सेल्स लाइक दिस फॉर स्क्वैमस, इट इज रॉन्ग. गॉट इट? ओके, डिफरेंस इज क्लियर ना? यहाँ पे हमने बल्ज्ड बनाया है, कुछ नहीं, ये नहीं बनाना, अपने फ्लैट बनाना है, तो इसलिए ये फ्लैट एंड मैंने टॉप दिया इसका. सो दिस इज स्क्वायर शेप सेल्स दैट विच मेक्स अ फ्लैट थिन लेयर एंड दीज आर एनिमल सेल्स, सो द न्यूक्लियस विल बी फाउंड ऑलमोस्ट इन द सेंटर, नो सेंट्रल वैक्यूल, सैप वैक्यूल अलॉन्ग विद द साइटोप्लाज्म. सो दिस इज वॉट द एनिमल सेल दैट विच कंप्राइज द एनिमल टिश्यू, दैट विच makes up the animal tissue. Got it? Now label the various parts of it. This is the cell membrane. Then is the cytoplasm. Nucleus of all the cells. And lastly, this is the basement membrane on which the epithelial cells, the epithelial tissue that will be arranged. Got it? So this was the first type, that is squamous epithelium. Second type which we wrote was cuboidal epithelium. So coming to the cuboidal, as the name is saying, it is cube shape. Okay, sorry, we forgot to write the location. Just write up the location also for squamous. Squamous epithelium, this is present or located in the walls of blood vessel. This is present in the walls of blood vessels as well as in the air sac of lungs. This also provides the inner lining of the mouth. Okay, it also provides inner lining of mouth. So that are the squamous epithelial tissues. Structure I wrote here. These are the location points, diagram, and functions are common. Okay, for all the types, you are to study the structure, function, location, and the diagram. Okay. सारे टिश्यूज के लिए ये चार चीजें आपने जरूर करनी है, स्ट्रक्चर, फंक्शन, लोकेशन एंड डायग्राम. ओके, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट. नाउ कमिंग टू द सेकंड टाइप, दैट इज क्यूबॉइडल एपिथेलियम. क्यूबॉइडल एपिथेलियल टिश्यू और क्यूबॉइडल एपिथेलियम, दैट इज एज द नेम इज सेइंग, व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इट, इट इज क्यूब शेप्ड, है ना, क्यूब शेप स्ट्रक्चर होगा ना इसका, बिकॉज इट इज शोइंग cuboidal, so they are having the cells which are cube shaped, so three dimensional structure plus providing a cushiony type of the, you can say, top surface. ठीक है, as they are big they are wide. ठीक है, जितने ये लंबे हैं उतने ही ये वाइड भी हैं. I'm making the same in this same structure, मैं यहीं पे बना रही हूँ, you will be making it a different one. ठीक है, separate बनाना है इसको. So this is a basement membrane and the cuboidal epithelium will be also made on the basement membrane similarly, hai na, so that is, these are cube shaped, so they are more wide and more lengthened. theek hai, as compared to the squamous, because wo thin or flat hai, ye thin nahi hai, and they also provide the cushiony surface. theek hai, so because they provide the cushiony surface, we have to make it as a bulged structures like this. So similarly, the width and the length should be almost similar. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द सेल मेम्ब्रेन, ऑल द मेम्ब्रेन, दीज आर ऑफ एनिमल सेल्स, अगेन द न्यूक्लियाई दैट हैज बीन एनलार्ज्ड इवन, एंड दीज न्यूक्लियाई दैट विल बी, दीज आर द न्यूक्लियाई एंड सराउंडेड बाय द सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स इमर्स्ड इन द साइटोप्लाज्म. So this is the cytoplasm. Basement membrane, same structure, but only the structural differences are there. Cuboidal epithelium. दिस क्यूबॉइडल एपिथेलियम विल बी प्रेजेंट अमंग इज द ट्यूबुलर पार्ट ऑफ योर बॉडी. ठीक है, बिकॉज इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग सम कुशनी स्ट्रक्चर, दैट इज इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग सम स्ट्रक्चर लाइक इट इज हैविंग यू कैन से हार्श सर्फेस नहीं दे रहा, इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग सम सॉफ्टनेस टू द सर्फेस, है ना. सो इट ऑल्सो कैरीज सम डेलीकेट थिंग्स अलॉन्ग विद इट. ठीक है, इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग द पाथवे टू द डेलीकेट पैसेजेस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल फिलोपियन ट्यूब्स. ठीक है, सो वट इज इट्स लोकेशन वेयर यू कैन फाइंड दिस क्यूबॉइडल एपिथेलियम? इट इज फाउंड इन द फिलोपियन ट्यूब्स. Fallopian tube, that is to carry the or the oviduct, what we call it as the oviduct or the fallopian tube, that is because it carries the ova through this. When the ovulation takes place through the ovary, out from the ovary into the oviduct or the fallopian tubes goes the ova, hai na. So that is made up of the cuboidal lining, right. Thirdly, there is okay, location we were studying. फंक्शन इसका सेम है, एब्जॉर्प्शन लाइनिंग एंड सेपरेशन. लोकेशन में इट इज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द रीनल ट्यूब्यूल्स. ठीक है, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द पार्ट्स ऑफ द नेफ्रॉन. रीनल ट्यूब्यूल्स कहाँ पड़ी हैं आपने? दैट इज इन द नेफ्रॉन्स, है ना. दैट इज द पीसीटी एंड द डीसीटी एंड ऑल. सो रीनल ट्यूब्यूल्स में भी ये प्रेजेंट होता है, दैट इज अ क्यूबॉइडल एपिथेलियल टिश्यू. दिस इज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द डक्ट्स ऑफ द ग्लैंड्स, नॉट ऑल द ग्लैंड्स बट अ फ्यू ग्लैंड्स. दे आर ऑल्सो हैविंग the ducts of these, ducts of the glands, not all but a few, they are also having cuboidal epithelial tissue. Got it? Structure clear? Structure is this much, that is they have the cube shaped structure, the cells are as wide, they are as long. Okay, have the prominent nuclei, big size nuclei that is located in the center. They are present over the basement membrane, that makes up its structure. Function we have done three functions, absorption, secretion and lining, and the location is all these parts. Okay, cuboidal epithelium can further be ciliated or glandular. Cuboidal epithelium jo hai ye aage ciliated or glandular bhi ho sakta hai, aise columnar bhi hota hai jo ki ciliated or glandular dono tarah se ban sakte hain. Matlab kya kehne ka, that among is the lining of the cuboidal epithelium, let's say this is the whole lining of the cuboidal epithelium, a few cells also in some parts they are having the shape of the cube cells, cube shaped cell hai, hai na, but they are having the cilia on the surface as well, so we will be calling them as ciliated cuboidal epithelium. Okay, in your 9th you haven't studied the ciliated cuboidal, you just studied the ciliated columnar, right, in your 9th from your tissues chapter, but here this can also be ciliated. So in a few parts of your body the cuboidal cells may be compared with the cilia, so making it a tissue which is called as ciliated cuboidal epithelial tissue. Similarly, because they provide the secretion as well, hai na, humne kaha na ki ye khud se bhi secretions dete hain, jaise aapne padha hua hai, that is for your information, tubular parts also secrete out the materials, hai na, tubular secretion. So, yahan pe these of the parts, that is some of the parts of the body again, if they are having the association with the cube-like cells, but they are secretive in nature, means the glands are also associated with the cuboidal epithelium. That can be glandular cuboidal epithelium tissue. Okay? So, this is a cuboidal epithelium. Similarly, the columnar also has the two types, that is the ciliated as well as glandular forms. ठीक है, सो नाउ द लास्ट, दैट इज द सिंपल थर्ड टाइप ऑफ द सिंपल टिश्यू, दैट इज कॉलमनर, द थर्ड टाइप ऑफ, वन सेकंड, द थर्ड टाइप ऑफ द टिश्यू दैट इज कॉलमनर एपिथेलियल टिश्यू. एज द नेम इज सेइंग कॉलमनर, नाउ द कॉलमनर एपिथेलियम टिश्यू, वी हैव टू मेक दैट. The column means that they are more tall, more long than wide, hai na. Column ka to matlab yahi hua, column means it is more tall and thin than wide, right. So again I'm making the diagram here, you please draw a separate membrane, basement membrane separately bana lena, theek hai, uske upar banana hai, right. So this is the column shaped cell. Here in this the cells have been more elongated than wide. So this is the cell shape. They are more elongated than wide.
इवन द न्यूक्लियस दैट हैज ऑल्सो बिकेम इलोंगेटेड रादर देन बिकमिंग ब्रॉड, है ना, जैसा वो क्यूबॉइडल में ब्रॉड हो गया था ऐसा नहीं है. नाउ द न्यूक्लियस विल ऑल्सो बी ब्रॉड. क्लियर? फर्स्टली द लेबलिंग पोर्शंस, दिस इज द सेल मेम्ब्रेन, राइट, द साइटोप्लाज्म विल बी समवेयर हियर एंड द न्यूक्लियस विल जस्ट लेबल. ओके,
सो दीज हैव द न्यूक्लियस ऑल्सो दैट विच आर इलोंगेटेड. द न्यूक्लियाई पोजिशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हियर. दे हैव बीन एक्सटेंडेड एंड दे आर प्रेजेंट टू द नियर टू द बेस. ठीक है, आपने इसको टॉप सरफेस के पास नहीं बनाना न्यूक्लियस को. इनमें ये स्पेशल फीचर है कि जो न्यूक्लियस है एक तो भी इलोंगेटेड हो गया, सेंटर में नहीं बनाना, सेल्स की साइड वॉल्स के पास पास बनाना है. सो सिमिलर लाइक दिस यू हैव टू मेक द इलोंगेटेड न्यूक्लियाई एंड ऑल्सो मेक श्योर दैट दीज न्यूक्लियाई आर नॉट नियर द सर्फेस और इन द सेंटर. दे आर नियर टू द वॉल्स, ओके, ईदर ऑफ द वॉल्स एंड टू द बेस. क्लियर? सो यू कैन मेक इट एनी वेयर बट नियर टू द वॉल एंड नियर टू द बेस. लेफ्ट बनाओ, राइट बनाओ, जहां पे मर्जी, बट इट इज लाइक एक्सटेंडेड लाइक दिस नियर टू द बेस. ओके, कैन बी अ बिट अबव बट नॉट मच अबव. इसलिए आई एम शोइंग ऑल द कंडीशंस व्हिच आर पॉसिबल दैट फॉर द न्यूक्लियस. ओके, दिस इज इट. Right? And these are the nuclei. So यहाँ पे भी इस सेल के भी अपने न्यूक्लियस बना देना. This is a okay. And the cytoplasm. This is a whole cytoplasm. Similarly, the cells of the columnar also bear cilia. If they are having the cilia, they will be called as ciliated columnar epithelium. And if the cells gets modified forming the glands, then it is glandular columnar epithelium, glandular ciliated columnar epithelium. Okay, so this is the columnar epithelium tissue. Fine, the columnar epithelium tissue that makes up the lining of the alimentary canal, right? The ciliated columnar that makes up the lining of the respiratory tract. So that are the locations for this, right? You can write down that is the location is either an alimentary canal. This may be seen in the alimentary canal or as lining of respiratory tract, but that are the ciliated columnar. Okay, ciliated columnars, they form the respiratory tract's lining. Fine. If they are having the cilia, as I told you, they can be both ciliated and glandular as well. Okay. If they are having the cilia, what is the cilia's location? It is on the surface. So just beneath the surface, there arises the basal granule. From there comes out the cilia like this. Okay, from the top surface, you will be making the circles. Like if this is the top surface, the circle that is the basal granules are just below this and comes out the cilia. Okay, so you will be just labeling this as the cilia and the basal granule and cover up the whole of the portion like this. Glandular ka concept aapko kal main karwa dungi. So this is the cilia and these parts, they are called as the basal granules. Right? So glandular we'll be doing it tomorrow. Okay? Anybody having any doubt, any question?